7.8.9 A knuckle blow is delivered to the solar plexus in three different situations. 7. As shown here with equal opponents, the probable effects would be pain, disorientation, and gasping for breath. 8. Delivered at the angle shown and in the relationship of size and build illustrated, the probability of injury is dramatically increased. There could be referral shock to the spleen and to other vital internal organs. 9. When used by a smaller, slighter person against a heavier, stronger person, the identical blow has little effect. 10.11.12 Practical self-defense techniques are those which depend to the least degree upon relative power, size and build. Kicking into the knee or shin is an example of a highly practical self-defense action. Though the effect would be different in different size relationships, the major advantage of this kick is shown in all three photos. The person kicking at the assailant does not have to come within fist or hand range of the assailant. 10. An adversary of approximately equal size is vulnerable to a kick into the knee or shin. 11. Kicking against a smaller person involves a considerably greater possibility of inflicting injury. 12. Although the probability of injury is considerably less when the same kick is delivered by a small person against a larger adversary, it is an effective technique for practical self-defense. In contrast to the kick into the knee or shin, which can be effective for small or large people, the tactic shown in 13.14 and 15 is virtually useless for a small person and is a high risk of injury blow if applied by a strong, large person against someone slight or frail.